Hi, so in this video I'm going to be looking at parametric equations, and we're going to be trying to turn parametric equations into their Cartesian form. Now when we're talking about the Cartesian form, we're talking about just writing an equation in terms of x and y as you have traditionally done, and the parametric equations are two separate equations where you have x and y in different equations in terms of another variable. So you see here I have x in terms of t and y in terms of t. Okay, so I've got these parametric equations here, and I want them in the Cartesian form. And really, when you do this, it's some form of substitution and manipulation. Sometimes you have to be quite imaginative, sometimes it's very straightforward. Now, this one, I think, is fairly straightforward. I just take my x equals 3t, I rearrange it to make t the subject of the equation, and then I substitute it back into my t squared. And so I get y equals x over 3 over t squared. Now this one, I can see that I've got a plus-minus relationship, and it would be quite hard to sort of get a single t equals out of this. So what I'm going to do is try adding and subtracting and seeing where I go from that. Now sometimes I try something and it doesn't work, and then I have to try something else, and that's fine. That's the way of this sort of question. So if I do x plus y, the t over 2's disappear and I get 2t cubed. And I do y minus x, the t cubes disappear this time, and then I get t over 2 minus minus t over 2, which gives me just t. And now I can see I've got this t on its own, and I feel much more comfortable about substituting. So then I can substitute this t in this expression. So I get x plus y equals 2, and that t cubed becomes y minus x cubed. Okay, so you might have to do one where you've got parametric equations which use trig functions, and that's fine. You need to know your trig identities. You're sort of just going to have to look at them and see what's connected. So I can see I've got the sine 2t, and I know the trig identity that sine 2t equals 2 sine t cos t. And I'm sort of quite happy about that because it's got this sine t in there. And so I'm feeling quite comfortable. And then I think, oh, cos t. Now, actually, I can always relate cos and sine together using sine squared plus cos squared equals 1. And so I can get my cos t from that, so cos t will equal the square root of 1 minus sine squared. So putting these two together, I get sine 2t equals 2 sine t square root of 1 minus sine squared t, and then you can see I can substitute x for my sine 2t, and I can substitute y equals sine t every time I see that. And so I put them in here, and I get x equals 2y square root of 1 minus y squared. And that's fine. That's a Cartesian equation. It's an equation just with x and y's in. You don't always have to have it so you get y equals something or x equals something. As long as you've just got only x and y's and no t's left, you've done what they've wanted you to do. Okay, I hope that's helpful. Bye.